大家好，稍微等一下，等大家都来了以后，开始直播。
When Tunisia started in December, I got a call from London, and that was a British producer working for Al Jazeera English, and very bright woman, and she called me and I was meeting some people you know from Tunisia, and they told me that you worked with these guys, and I'm very interested in what's going to happen. And if you look at Egypt, where do you see chance? And Egypt was not even on the agenda. I mean, it's like nobody was expecting it. There were still minor problems in Tunisia, in the world of the big media. It's like the protests in Tunisia, these were the titles in the newspapers in the Western world. And then Caroline Pair is the name of that person. Very, very good producer. She was rewarded many times for her TV features. And then I said, listen, if something happens in Tunisia, it will happen around two groups. One is April 6th, another one is April 5th. I can put in touch with these people, but I don't have an idea whether or not they would like to speak for camera because they live in Mubarak City. So, I mean, it's up to you to persuade them. And she said, okay. And somehow she found a journalist who was crazy enough to go inside the movement. So what you're going to see now is got, what do you call this? It's not People TV. It's Grammy Emmy. What's for TV? So this is Emmy.
Emmy Award-winning?
This is Emmy Award-winning half an hour thing, which came to this world because somebody was crazy enough to be with this guy, even arrested with this guy. She even was jailed. And this starts, and this was broadcasted 2 days before Mubarak stepped out. So it ends with Mubarak saying he's not going to step out. I mean, this is the part of the history. Of course, you know what happened next. So, I mean, you'll see some of my good friends, like Mohammed Adel. What I would love you to look at, and what we can discuss later, is this strategy, unity, nonviolent discipline, tactics, because it's all there. Okay? Lights off. Watching the movies.
Hello, everyone. This is People in Power, and I'm Summer Al-Shahat. On today's program, Egypt's Seeds of Change.
إن الحشد يريد على الإنترنت وعلى سائل المحادثات الشعب يتكلم بصورة كبيرة.
It's widely accepted that the spark for the recent dramatic events in Egypt came from last month's uprising in Tunisia. If people power could bring down one despotic regime, so the thinking went, then perhaps it could do the same elsewhere. Many of the necessary conditions were already in place. Public fury at years of political repression, an economy that rewarded a corrupt elite and kept a majority in poverty, and widespread loathing for a leader clinging to office. But could Egyptians be persuaded to overcome 30 years of fear and apathy and take to the streets? Well, it's no accident that question was answered emphatically. Over the first remarkable 10 days of the protest, People in Power filmed exclusively and behind the scenes with a core group of young activists from the April 6th opposition movement. As Elizabeth Jones reveals, they had spent many months planning and organizing for these momentous times, even taking lessons from other revolutions about how to mobilize popular support.
They say it's been a leaderless revolution, but somewhere in the side streets of Cairo, there are leaders, and they're planning. Ahmed Maher is the leader of this April 6th youth movement, the main instigator of this revolution, and the one to whom they turn. In the street below their ad hoc offices, the revolution they spawned is in full swing. April 6th and their charismatic leaders have been directing the uprising from the start. They've brought a sense of freedom and unity to the streets of Egypt.
You know everyone.
Yeah.
You know everyone.
Ah, these are friends in political area.
The fact they've brought the aging president to the brink of departure is almost unbelievable. They're excited at the prospect of change after 30 years. There's almost a carnival atmosphere, but this is not a spontaneous uprising. The revolution has been in the making for 3 years. It was at a textile strike in 2008 that the April 6th youth movement was born. Ahmed Maher had enlisted support for the workers on his Facebook site, gaining 70,000 followers. The demonstration was the biggest Egypt had seen in years and inspired the creation of the April 6th youth movement. They began work mobilizing for democratic change. They've been trying to get people on the streets ever since. It's not easy in politically apathetic Egypt, the population worn down by decades living in fear under a corrupt, repressive regime. With no history of dissent in Egypt, Ahmed Maher looked outside for help to people who'd successfully overthrown dictators, like Otpor, the Serbian student movement that toppled Slobodan Milosevic. Serge Popovic was leader of that revolution. He shared his first-hand experience with April 6th.
One of the key things is to understand that the nonviolent struggle is a form of warfare. Nonviolent discipline, this is key. Because violence contaminates your movement and creates your opponent's excuse for using police and military forces. Also, there is this big problem with media and violence. If you have a march of 100,000 people and one single idiot throwing stone, he's going to be the star of the day. And this is how media operates. So you need to avoid this violence in many different ways. And this is specifically crucial at this stage.
اولا درسنا في صربيا درسنا على فكره ان احنا ايه هو مفهوم العنف ازاي نقدر نحرك الجماهير بجد على عمل العنيف وازاي ان احنا نقدر نساوي دوت نقدر نتحكم في الناس نقدر ننظم مسيرات وفعاليات كويسه.
Mohamed Adel came back from Serbia with videos and teaching aids. Popovic, in his own voice, explaining tactics. The keys to success are unity, discipline, and planning. Keep people engaged with chants and slogans, and be clear in your aims. It appears to work.
Oh!
started to come together 2 weeks ago. It's a public holiday in Egypt, a day to celebrate the police. But today is a police day with a difference.
حاجة سخرانة الشرطة عملنا بيان وزعنا الشرطة ده زي احتفلوا بالبلطجية والحرامية واللي بيساعدوا على التزوير والكلام ده كله ولكن ما حدث في تونس غير المسار الكامل
والوظيفة راح تيجي
This year the timing couldn't have been happier for the organizers. A few days ago, Tunisian people power ousted the country's dictator. The response in Egypt is beyond Ahmed Maher's dreams. Tens of thousands have come out to join the April 6th youth movement in Cairo, and there are similar family-friendly marches in Alexandria, Suez, and Mansoura. But not everyone is happy. The police are in no mood to celebrate. April 6th is well-versed in the tactics of non-violent conflict. They hold their hands up in compliance, they salute, and even hug the police. Protesters are heading to iconic Tahrir Square. They are largely young, educated, computer literate crowd.
I heard about April 6th from Facebook. I'm not into politics. I just I wanted to do something for my country, something positive. That's the happiest day of my life.
The protesters don't want to go home. Many seem determined to continue. Camped out for the night. Some say that what happened in Tunisia can't happen in Egypt. These people don't appear to have heard. April 6th has scrambled to set up the secret headquarters, a nerve center for what they are starting to call the revolution. It's a borrowed office, and it's rapidly turning into an operation room for something bigger than even they could have hoped for. Ahmed Maher is coordinating his people, conscious of the responsibility on his shoulders. It's now Thursday night. Tens of thousands of protesters have been on the streets since Tuesday. There have been clashes with police and some arrests. Ahmed Maher is, as ever, on his computer, communicating with his activists online. It turns out his right-hand man, Mohamed Adel, has been arrested. In his other life, Ahmed Maher is a professional man, married with a child.
ممكن يكون دوت مثال وبرضه الحاجة أول ما اخترع زي ما بيقولوا يعني. إذا مثلا محتاج أعمل حاجة معينة بتعلمها يعني مع الوقت. خصوصا أنا كمان مش حد إداري ولكن تعامل مع الناس وأتعامل مع الناس كويس.
He'll need those skills with possibly hundreds of thousands expected on the streets tomorrow and politicians from all opposition factions getting in on the act.
يوم أتوقع أنه يبقى أكبر بكثير من يوم الـ 25 وإن الحشد كبير جدا على الإنترنت وعلى رسائل وحتى ناس في الشارع بتتكلم بصورة كبيرة وهيبقى خروج من مساجد كتير في القاهرة وفي المحافظات هيبقى العدد كبير في مناطق شعبية والجماعة برضه عم تحل بس أتوقع أنه يكون عدد أكبر بكثير من يوم الثلاثة.
It's been a long day. Tomorrow promises to be longer. Friday dawns. They're calling it the Day of Rage. Mohamed Adel has been freed overnight. He's drafting a press release with Islam Luka.
مجرد إن أمن شافني في العربية نزلني من العربية ونزل فيا طح الأمن نزل فيا ويتحمل بالبوكس وبالعصيان كان في اسماعيل الشهاب من جنوب القاهرة نزل في الأرض قال لي خدوها على العربية غير كده كمان إضافي الضباط في الشارع كل ظابط شافني عملتوا ثورة بقيتوا زي تونس خلي الفيسبوك ينفعكم.
He's straight back into work. Now he's sorting out a list of mosques and churches where people can gather, arranging the routes the protesters will take towards Tahrir Square. Maher's plan is that after Friday prayers across the capital, marchers will converge on Tahrir Square. Mobile phones and the internet, the key organizational tools of April 6th, all cut off by the government. They're going prepared in case of attack. There are guidelines on what to wear and how to act in the streets. They go in groups of four or five. They don't wear April 6th insignia. This is not about the group, they say, but about unity of all Egyptians in the goal of deposing the Mubarak regime.
جمع الناس في مسيرات سلمية اتجه من دليل تحرير من كذا منطقة حوالي أربع مناطق بس من المناطق الشعبية جدا من الطبقة اللي هي فقيرة جدا من الناس عشان هي دي الطبقة اللي حاصلة على المشاكل الاقتصادية اللي احنا أصبحنا فيها دلوقتي.
They are heading to Abusseya, a neighborhood in the north of Cairo. After the unexpected success of Tuesday's rally, their ambition is to get a million people out on the square today. Everyone in the movement has their job. This group is responsible for marshalling support in this district and getting people into the square. But not everyone is happy with what's happening. In Tahrir Square, other April 6 groups are already at work. Back at headquarters, they've been donated a satellite dish and TV. With rumors abounding, the only way to get any information is via satellite TV news.
Now Baradei and his followers say they are being beaten in Giza Square, and some news about 4,000 soldiers from the army are in the streets, now in the main squares in the streets. We don't know exactly, is it right or wrong, because no way to communicate with anybody.
But then things start to get hairy.
They are beating people in the streets.
One group of protesters is being prevented by police from getting to Tahrir Square. Protesters have been forced up side roads to the April 6th headquarters, the police in hot pursuit. It looks like they'll be pushed back. But more protesters are arriving from another district. The police can't guard every access route. So the crowd swells. It's April 6th strategy in action. Then surprise, everything stops for prayers. The police turn their backs in a gesture of respect. But once prayers are over, the protesters are back to it. People appear to be surrounding the police. And then they break through to Tahrir Square. Already, people are arriving from the streets to make use of the makeshift clinic April 6th have set up.
التحرير من الدين للأمن عدد صغير جدا. قال لك زادوا عن 20,000 كمان. فوبعدين لو بنروح مشكلين معاك اتنينات كده مع بعض بس لو احنا رايحين تحرير بقى الناس حضراتكم جهزوا لنا الحاجات زي كده خلي بقى بصوا وشوفوا اللي انتوا عندكم ايه الدنيا تحت بتضوء حاجات غريبه ممهدين الشباب هم ضرب مباشر في جسم الشباب.
The main problems are tear gas injuries to the eyes and shortness of breath due to gas inhalation.
اللي هي 994
يعني منتهى الصلاحية كمان
في خبر جاي ان في مزارع لو عند قصر الجمهوري في صلاح سالم في تحركات في 150 ألف في اسكندرية وفي أماكن تانية كتيرة فيها مظاهرات
beaten up by the sticks of the central security soldiers Ramses Street
The office is starting to resemble an emergency room.
Our aim is democracy and freedom for this country. And it's great to see that now all the people had managed to get rid of the excessive fear and loss of hope that had always crippled them for years from standing up for their rights. And now they have hope, and now they don't have fear. Any longer, and they can't stand in front of this brutal force.
People are recounting details from all across town. Despite the excitement, the day ends on a bad note when police are withdrawn from the streets and looting starts. That night, they watched the reports of the events they put in train. The ruling party headquarters is on fire. It's confirmed the army is on the streets, and the police have been completely withdrawn. The protesters are delighted to see the back of the police and the brutality. They hope the army will stop the violence. There's optimism in the air. April 6 members work throughout the night, protecting Tahrir Square from pro-Mubarak supporters, ensuring the safety of protesters sleeping there. It's just 6 days since Ahmed Maher first inspired his supporters to come out for that police day protest. His mind is already on the future.
عايزين بلد يظهر في الفترة الحالية بحيث ان التجنب بمود فراغ في مصر من دولة المجرور وجديد استمرار الحزب الوطني هيحصل فراغ لهم مشوا وكانوا في مخطط النهاردة يعمل الاجتماع حوالين طرح بلد بصورة مباشرة ولكن للأسف تليفوني ضاع امبارح في المظاهرات يعني فلسه بحاول اتصل بيه تاني دلوقتي بحيث نقعد مع بعض.
With the demonstrations going well, Maher feels confident enough to hold a press conference in the safe house.
اسم الدكتور البلد هل مطلوب بالنسبه للحركه او في يعني في ميادين المشاورات بين القوى السياسيه المختلفه والحركه حتى هذه اللحظه في اجتماعات ما بين مختلف الاطراف السياسيه في مصر التوافق حوالين الخطبه الموحده او الكفيل
الخروج من مأزق وتشكيل حكومة وطنية، ولكن الاسم تيوب بردها يلازال مطروح تمرشح لفترة انتقالية.
They were asked how long they would be able to keep protesters in the square. They want the world to know they have victory in their sights. But they'll need support to be victorious. Ahmed Maher is well aware that the military is crucial to the outcome of this process, and having the army on board was an early priority.
حصل اتصال من بعض الضباط جوه الجيش، ده الكلام ده كان يوم السبت اللي فات، وعرضوا ان هم ممكن يساندونا، ولكن الكل السياسيه عملت اتصالات سريعه بدأ دايما نور ومعظم الشخصيات السياسيه، ولكن فضلوا ان هو يكون الحديث مع القياده المركزيه للجيش مش مع احد الفروع في الجيش.
من يتوجه لحديث اليوم مباشرة لأبناء الشعب.
President Mubarak is on state television addressing the nation. Expectations are high and no one wants to miss it.
إنني لم أكن يوما طالب سلطة أو
No one believes him. And sure enough, he says he's not willing to relinquish power now. The reaction here is unsurprising. The next day, thousands of pro-Mubarak supporters flooded Tahrir Square, and running battles ensue. It's certainly not over. Cairo has now become chaotic and dangerous, with machete-wielding gangs roaming the streets. Then the military police raided the April 6th headquarters. Later, pictures appeared on the internet of the trashed offices. I was in the street outside and detained for a few hours. Ahmed Maher was in the square. But the 15 activists who were inside at the time were arrested and taken away. Among them, Amar, Amal, and Khaled. With President Mubarak still in power and the protests in Tahrir Square continuing, this drama is far from over. But whatever the final outcome, the young activists who brought it about have achieved near miracles. They've woken their countrymen and women from years of apathy and fear. Egypt will never be the same again.
The three detained activists mentioned at the end of that film, Amir Ali, Ahmed Sharaf, and Khaled Ali, have now been released. That's it for this edition of People in Power. If you'd like to comment on this episode or any other matter, we'd love to hear from you on aljazeera.net/English. Until next time, bye-bye.
Hello, 大家好，已经完了，一共多少分钟？哦，这现在还没法看，可能也就多少时间？我看一下，我现在看不出来时间，也就一二十分钟吧。他这个就是在那个莫巴拉克逃出埃及前两天发生的事情，他们当时并没有预计到，你看那个节目最后那个解说人说的，他们并没有预计到两天后莫巴拉克就会滚蛋，埃及就会他们的运动成功了。你看我们在这个小活动中，他们是这个当时组织者，他们那些组织这个活动，他们也不知道他们什么时候会成功，反正就是不停的坚持。你看我们在他这个视频里面，他们这个活动中最学到的最有用的一个经验是什么呢？就是他们内部啊，组织内部，他们一共是十几个人，15个加那个没被抓的，一共16个人。他们每个人都有明确的分工，你看有的人负责宣传，有的人负责食物和水，还有的人他负责 到处去告诉别人哪儿可以有食物，可以有水，所以这些都明确的分工很重要。你像我们中国人一有事就是，哎呀你干吧你干吧，都指望一两个组织者，这是很不好的，这都是这个中共产党的这个不良影响造成的。共产党的这些是土匪出身的家伙，都是什么事指望别人，希望别人都是他们的奴才。所以这个我们将来在运动中一定要注意，每个人都有明确的分工，不明确你也没办法。只要我们要负责这个，要有水啊，要有宣传的，要有摄像的呀，要有上网传播的呀，那具体到人，而且还要有备用人，而且还要有联络人，所以这些都非常重要。另外一个就是大家都很充满了信心，你看他最后说，就是因为这十几个年轻人组织的活动，他们开始组织十几万，后来他们期待组织一百万，其实到场的这个十来万人，十五万。但是这个你没想到啊，他们也没想到啊，他才组织十万人，两天以后就把穆巴拉克给赶跑了。他主要是你看最后解说员说他驱除了人民的恐惧，但是我们现在中国远远没有达到这个程度。你像他们这个视频里面说，他们提前三年就在组织了，就在准备了。所以我们现在第一个阶段我们也要思想发展人。你看现在中国各个群体已经很多了，包括这业余爱好群体啊，还有这些一些维权群体啊，特别你像这个涉及的公众安全，或者说公众食品安全呢、生命安全呢，这些大家平时都在讨论。所以关键是要在这些讨论中要告诉他们民主自由制度应该怎么运行，怎么能够保障普通人的权益。另外一个就是告诉他们国外的这些非暴力成熟的组织方法。所以我们就这是我发表的两点意见，希望大家如果你们需要有什么看法的，也可以在下面留言，然后进行讨论。啊，这个是怎么呢？索尼火眼说的，啊，就分工很重要。然后就是他不知道中国是否开始准备了，他意思说真正的长远的准备，这个肯定有人在做。我估计这个，你像在美国，他们有一些这个，他不是官方的，但是他是这个学者或者对这个世界有责任感的人组织的。像民主推动啊，像以前我上次提到那个刚去世的议员麦凯恩，他也参加过竞选总统，他也一直在推动这些运动。他因为是在那个越南越战的时候受到过共产党，当过共产党的俘虏，受到残酷的压迫，他对这个共产党统治非常了解，所以他一直致力于在世界各地推翻这个共产党的独裁统治。我相信包括这个美国的一些这样的组织，包括其他国家的一些组织，甚至不知道这CIA 不知道他们有没有在中国也进行这些活动，但是肯定在做，只不过是因为毕竟他们是外国人，他们他不愿意大张旗鼓的宣传的话就会被共产党反面利用，说他们是国外势力啊什么宣传，其实这是他们只是多虑而已。人民中国老百姓都是能知道自己的立场，知道自己的处境的，他知道这些人对他们的权利有益，他不会就真正的被共产党挑动的，只不过是共产党只会在他们控制的媒体上进行宣传，反美宣传，什么外国势力渗透啊，什么外国势力插手啊，这些进行宣传而已。我们作为中国人，我们就应该毫无顾虑的在网上宣传。你像我们宣传这些理念，包括联合国的各种公约，包括中国的宪法中规定的公民权利自由，包括这世界各国的民主国家的规定的，其他是如何在实践中保障的。你像我讲的那个各国政治制度里面都有，下次我会讲那个新加坡的，就是作为一个参照。新加坡很多人也会推崇新加坡的模式。有时候就是像那个网上说那个胡适说的一句话，就是你自己作为一个奴隶，你反而天天为奴隶主操心，国家威权只会对统治阶级有利，对那500个家族有利，你一个屁民，被剥削的屁民，即使你是他们的一些附庸，靠给他们当打手挣点钱，也没有尊严的，就一条狗， 你哪有这个像德国的人流浪汉政府每个月都要给他几百欧元的补贴，然后给他免费买医疗保险，治病不要钱，是不是？你他们政府也给他们房租，补贴房租，他有些人他不愿意住房，他就愿意在外面流浪，但是政府也不放弃他。你像这样的国家，这样的制度才是能保障人的，你有了生存保障，你才有尊严嘛。不然的话，你成天为了生存卑躬屈膝，你看你是哪有尊严的？所以就是，我们就要告诉他们，这种制度才能保障每个人的尊严，保障他家人的尊严，包括他没有文化，一直在农村受穷受苦的父母的尊严。所以就是，希望我们能够进行大量的宣传。这只不过是在网上，能在国外安全的朋友就应该就毫无顾虑的大张旗鼓的宣传。你宣传这些，国宝也不可能把你家人怎么样。你又没有搞什么武装反抗什么的，对他也没有直接威胁。国内的朋友，你也可以通过各种方式，匿名什么，或者在小圈子里面不匿名，你发这个国际政治公约，国外的这个人们的生活案例。法院判例、刑法、宪法规定、经济法，你包括美国的、德国的民法，它就规定要保障这个，它的民法中也有很多对社会进行保障的，所以这些大家都可以讲，都可以宣传，我将来也会逐渐讲到的，我也会讲这个中东的，我们有一个学期专门学中东的情况，就拿 Austin。这是德语，英文叫 Middle East， 中东的情况，大家可以从他们的这个环境，从他们的情况中、历史啊、现状中学到很多东西。我们应该避免什么？应该学习什么的？我们今天就这样吧，也没看见别的人们发言的。如果大家可以有什么要发言，可以在下面留言。然后我在下次论坛节目中，和嘉宾呢、啊、和参与者一起讨论。这位网友也说，火眼索尼也说，在国内宣传法律还是安全的。一个是宣传法律安全，另外你宣传国外的这些案例也是安全的，就是他们是怎样保障的。共产党不能，因为你没说我要推翻共产党，你也没说共产党做的不对，你就宣传国外是怎么保障的就行。他们的法律、他们的制度，包括他们的法院、他们的政府，美国警察你是没有权利去把什么流浪汉抓进什么收容所的。他只有喝醉酒了、闹事了，你可以把他弄到那叫流容，就是在他那有一个地方，就你可以让他在睡一晚上，但是条件也非常好，一个人他要那个房间要大于15平方米，要有厕所，要有好的，要保暖。或者是叫什么夏天要制冷，然后要有足够的饮水食物，这些都要有保障的，所以这些大家都可以跟国内的人讲。因为很多人还觉得他活得不错，一些所谓的小叫什么小中产呢，还是没法跟他们的生活，其实就没法跟国外的流浪汉比。国外的流浪汉人家还可以休假，政府补贴钱给你多少钱，你去国外去休假，因为他认为这个休假也是人权，基本人权，他们也可以在国外长长见识，恢复生活的热情，说不定就开始不再做消极的流浪汉呢。但是他们也尊重个人选择，有人觉得流浪汉他就是一种生活方式，甚至是一种修行，一种信仰，所以政府也要保障他们的信仰。所以这个就都可以跟国内的朋友讲。这现在可能有些晚了，同时在线的人不多，但是大家可以看后面的这个，反正这个视频到时候它也会自动保存下来，大家可以再回播，我也可以把它，因为现在这个我的那个主频道也是被删了封号几个以后的第三个了，也多次跟那谷歌油管包括他们高管，包括通过法律手段，现在总算把这个频道又重新能用了。保下来了，但是还不能直播，要过一个月，12月14号才开始直播用。所以 我待会也会把这个视频再转到那个主频道上去，作为这个叫什么录像回播的，大家也可以看，然后在下面留言或者有什么感想，也可以跟我通过我的电报啊，或者是 Twitter 留言，然后我再综合一下，在下一次讨论和向大家提出。今天就这样了，祝大家晚安，拜拜。